by Deacon Marty and Rob. Deacon George, actually. So everybody please stand up now as we enter in worship. Let the praises ring.
the life of the Eucharist, the Native Americans and African American people. By her prayer and example, enable us to work for justice among the poor and the oppressed, and keep us undivided in love in the Eucharistic community of your church. For our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord God, if the wicked man turns away from all the sins he committed, if he keeps all my statutes and does what is right and just, he shall surely live, he shall not die. None of the crimes he committed shall be remembered against him. He shall live because of the virtue he has practiced. Do I indeed derive any pleasure from the death of the wicked, says the Lord God? Do I not rather rejoice when he turns from his evil way, that he may live? And if the virtuous man turns from the path of virtue to do evil, the same kind of abominable things that the wicked man does, can he do this and still live? None of his virtuous deeds shall be remembered, because he has broken faith and committed sin. Because of this, he shall die. You say, the Lord's way is not fair. Hear now, house of Israel, it is my way that is unfair. Or rather, are not your ways unfair? When someone virtuous turns away from the virtue to commit iniquity and dies, it is because of the iniquity he committed that he must die. But if the wicked, turning from the wickedness he has committed, does what is right and just, he shall preserve his life. Since he has turned away from all the sins that he committed, he shall surely live. He shall not die. The word of the Lord.
you. Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, I tell you, unless your righteousness surpasses that of the scribes and Pharisees, you will not enter into the kingdom of heaven. You have heard that it was said to your ancestors, you shall not kill, and whoever kills will be liable to judgment. But I say to you, whoever is angry with his brother will be liable to judgment, and whoever says to his brother, Raka, will be answerable to the Sanhedrin, and whoever says, you fool, will be liable to fiery Gehenna. Therefore, if you bring your gift to the altar, and there recall that your brother has anything against you, leave your gift there at the altar. Go first and be reconciled with your brother, and then come and offer your gift. Settle with your opponent quickly while on the way to court. Otherwise, your opponent will hand you over to the judge, and the judge will hand you over to the guard, and you will be thrown into prison. Amen, I say to you, you will not be released until you have paid the last penny. The Gospel of the Lord.
Thank you.
how did you mess that up? You know, how did you, something so easy, how did you mess this up? The mercy of God is so great. The mercy of God is for all of us. Now, my brothers and sisters, there's not a sin that you ever committed that I ever did. Our deepest, darkest secret, God knows. And Jesus died on the cross for that sin. And it's washed away by the blood of Jesus Christ. And the church said, amen. We've been redeemed by the blood of Jesus Christ. Now, as Catholics, we have this great sacrament of confession, of reconciliation. Now, if this sacrament was just for the forgiveness of sins, it would still be amazing. But when we go to the sacrament of reconciliation, of confession, not only do we get absolution of forgiveness of sins, but we get sanctifying grace that helps us grow in virtue to conquer the vices in our life. Does that make sense? See, sometimes we just miss that. And we just go, we get the absolution, and then we think we just go out and say, until next time. But the sacrament, the sanctifying grace, helps us grow in virtue. If I'm struggling with something, and I've grown in virtue, the church will teach us, Catholic teaching will say that virtue will conquer vice. And as long as I'm struggling with vices and seem to have a dominance in my life, I need to get as much sanctifying grace to grow in virtue as much as I can. So eventually, the virtue will conquer the vice. Right? That's not as easy as it sounds. But the grace of the sacrament of reconciliation is as easy as it sounds. We go in with your forgiveness of sins. We go in and we get sanctifying grace to conquer the challenges of our life. You know, this Lord, he just so loves us so much, and he makes everything available for us to grow in holiness. And so, the first part of my homily is just focusing on the first one, that we just turn from sin. Makes available this grace and the sacrament of reconciliation that will strengthen us to grow in holiness. And that's why I love about Lent. We're pretty serious about growing in holiness. And so we're determined. But I just pray that you make yourself available to all the grace that God has available for us in this morning so like this. That our life will just continue to be trajectory of running to the Lord. Amen? Now the second part of the homily has to do with the gospel. And it talks about reconciliation. So, many of us are gathered here tonight to pray for physical healing. And it's been my experience as a priest for 26 years, a lot of the afflictions and diseases that we struggle with and ailments that we struggle with, not all, but a lot, comes from unforgiveness in our heart. You know, that we hold grudges and it internalizes in ourselves and it does terrible things to our system. You know, we get high blood pressure, we get anxiety, we get so much, you know, angst in us. And yet the person that we're holding the grudge about, they're going about their lives like nothing's happening. So let me share a story. Many years ago, I was on a retreat, and there was a young man there that he looked beyond his ages, right? The man might have been in his 20s, but he looked like he was in his 50s. Why? Because this man's father abandoned him as a child, and he hated his dad. You know, you might say there's some righteous anger there, but the way he internalized it, manifested himself with a very ugly disposition. He was mad against the world. Everybody was his enemy. Everybody was out to get him. His face looked like a 50-year-old man until he was 20. beautiful thing says the sign of peace. We call it the sign of peace. And we ask, right before we come up to receive communion, to offer each other a sign of peace. And unfortunately, maybe we haven't taught the reason behind this liturgical movement. It's not just to shake the hand of the person next to you, to say hello to the person next to you. It is symbolizing that you are at peace with humanity. It's symbolizing that we don't hold any grudge. you are given to us tonight. We come to this Eucharistic celebration where He comes to us body, blood, soul, and spirit. The same Jesus on the cross that says, forgive them, Father, they do not believe. It's the same Jesus that we can call by name. This is the Jesus tonight. This is the Jesus we love. This is the Jesus tonight. Amen. Let us stand now.
Church leaders, may God provide wisdom and love to guide their action and decision. Let us pray to the Lord. For elected officials, may the Holy Spirit help them in creating a more just and peaceful world. Let us pray to the Lord. For those who suffer in war-stricken land, may Jesus sustain them and grant them hope. Let us pray to the Lord. For the member of this faith community, may God's love be our guide as we work to build His kingdom on earth. Let us pray to the Lord. For all who have died, may they soon enter the kingdom of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
We pray for all our petitions that have been communicated to us, and also for all those who are watching this healing mass live stream, that the Lord may grant our request and theirs according to His perfect will through Christ our Lord. Please be seated for our offertory. And tonight our collection will be taken up by our members and core members of our life team. be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Give us the right disposition, O Lord, we pray, to make these offerings, for with them we celebrate the beginning of the venerable and sacred time, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. Be you well that our self-denial should give you thanks. Humble our sinful pride, contribute to the feeding of the poor, and so help us imitate you in your kindness. And so we glorify you with countless angels, as with one voice of praise we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." Supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." As we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation. Giving thanks, you tell us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, David, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also brothers and sisters that have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles and all the saints, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you all.
Thank you.
holy refreshment of your sacrament, restore us anew, O Lord, and cleanse us of old ways. Take up into the mystery of salvation through Christ our Lord. Just before concluding our Mass and beginning of our healing service, just a few announcements. On March 18th, we'll be hosting a Lenten Day of Renewal here. It's going to be called Hope, based on my
Thank you.
presence of our Lord. He wants to minister healing to us. Our God desires us to be made whole. And we've been gathering every first Friday for many, many years. We hear many testimonies how the Lord works a sovereign act in people's lives for healing us. Tonight's service, especially since we prayed for forgiving everybody from our hearts. So we're free. We're free to receive all the mercy, the love, and the healing of Jesus. So I'd like to invite the teams from the Encounter School of Ministry to come forward. We'll just say a blessing over you at this point. And we'll send you to the perimeter of the church so we can so you can minister to other people. Any other teams from the School of Ministry? The one in the corner there? Lord God, we pray that your anointing of your Holy Spirit come upon these faithful servants. Lord God, as you work through your people through generations to bring healing, work through us tonight, that the body of Christ may be made whole. And we, your instruments, may give you glory and honor for the work you do. Lord, anoint them now with your Spirit. And we pray this in your holy name. To the perimeter of the church. We invite you to come up and Deacon George and I will pray over you. And then go to one of the teams. Don't leave without going to one of the teams. They are very anointed people. So Deacon George, you will take the Blessed Mother's side.
endures forever. He has healed us. He has blessed us. So give him a shout of praise, because he's a merciful God, faithful forever